in that aspect of our coverage.
Lock one.
Some good fortune to begin here for Chun Meng. Olympic champion takes that first point with the net.
One all.
As always here, as we always say, the lower ranked player here, out here, can you stay with your opponent early on here, not get cut adrift in the opening game? That's important. Come back against your experiences, I mean, at the highest level. Neha, when you're taking on a higher ranked player, I guess that's the imperative, isn't it? You want to stay with them, stay in the conversation, so to speak there.
Yeah, that's always, it's hard to stay in the game if the level doesn't match in terms of the speed, and especially the speed, because the top players, the Chinese, the Japanese, are just way too quick. It's always been a struggle to match their speeds.
Let 4-2. Four, three, five.
Egypt has also been, you know, producing good players with Dina Misrif in the women's side, Omar Asar in the men's singles side, and Yusra here, the third highest ranked Egyptian in the world. And, you know, the one thing that I love about table tennis is the number of countries that play this wonderful sport. You saw previously Argentina, from New Zealand, now from Egypt. Truly a global sport.
Just not hitting the ball that hard there, Chun Meng, relatively, but the placement is always, always so good from her. Another thinking player. Said this about Ma Long, didn't we, in the previous match? Oh, it's caught the back edge.
Eight.
On your back on your point about the Egyptians, though, I mean, they're building all the time with their. I know you were involved in development back in, you know, in your native country in India as well. They've done the same thing, but you can't get away from the fact that when you have players who do well, and they're on television and everything, that helps naturally. And so you've got Omar Asar, you've got Dina Meshref, and now you've got the one you didn't know, you've got Hannah Goda coming through, who is absolutely frighteningly good already. So, I mean, they're blessed with options, you know, on the TV at World Table Tennis Series events, with all the coverage now in the sport. Seems like they're in a really good place to take advantage of all of that. They're doing that. Like the Indians too, I would say. Another country that's well-placed. I'm not just saying that because you're in the booth.
Yeah, and I really hope Egyptians back home are watching this lady producing wonderful table tennis here in Durban. All the matches so far, I love that even despite the wide difference in the world ranking, the players are putting in their best effort.
10-5.
Finds the way through there, Chun. And here are 5 game points, the Olympic champion.
11-5.
Just needs the one. As Helmy misfires there.
Great,
you know how you've been, you know, working on WTT events, obviously those premium events, the best players play. If you think about the top tiers where Chun Meng is involved, you know, you think about the finals, you think about the Smash, the Singapore Smash, the Champions events, Star Contender 2, but those top tiers. Just felt with her, watching her, that she's kind of, at this point, There's even a bit more steeliness. Worlds is approaching, and the Olympic cycle now is getting serious. Now a year to go. That this is where Chun Meng goes into overdrive. That's the feeling you get. Not that she wasn't, you know, at the top of it before, but there's even a bit more of an upgrade here now because of what's on the line. You sensing that?
Yeah, for sure. And especially this Olympic cycle, because it is a compressed one. We have only 3 years. And she's played a lot of the tournaments on the World Tour. So obviously she is participating in way many tournaments to keep up the ranking. And just the pressure she has to be completing the Grand Slam ahead of the next year's Paris Olympics will be quite immense, because of course she will be wanting to be in Paris next year and winning the title again. Quite a lot demand from Chun Meng, from herself, but also I'm sure from the Chinese national team.
Of course, Yusra Helmi will hope to be there, but as you alluded to earlier, that's no surefire thing now with how many good Egyptian women there are around. There's work to do if you think about it, and the players who are involved. And of course, you're limited on the number of picks for the Olympics as well. It's more, even more stringent than here in terms of the numbers you can play.
Yeah, and I believe Hana was one of the youngest Olympians at Tokyo.
Yeah. Would have been even younger as well, of course, this with everything it delayed by a year, but was able to compete there.
8-1.
Controlling here with, again, all these elements of the Chun Meng game working nicely. That placement we talked about, variations.
But that was brilliant from Yusra Helmi, trying to match the speed, because if you were to steal a point from Chun Meng there, you got to punch harder. She tried her best.
1-10.
Staring down 9 game points here now, the Egyptian. Oh, the touch there after everything that had gone before. 2 down to Chun Meng. Just would have been first time a little bit, I think, Neha, the problem in that second game, the way it progressed, first time just starting to get away from her a little bit.
1-0.
Yeah, but just the effort that is from Helmi here, would like to applaud her for that. The scoreline doesn't depict the sort of points that we have seen in this match so far. You know, in the women's side, I always find it interesting to see how the women's player also trying to show off their jewels. And you can see Chun Meng's necklace. It has a table tennis racket. I don't know what it says on it. And Yusra Helmi's is the Olympic rings.
5-1.
The jewellery, it's Da Meng, I'm told. Nickname there.
5-2.
Well, dreaming big of this elusive world title, Chun Meng coming in. I mean, that is the narrative, you know, coming into this, if you think about it, is the piece of the puzzle, the piece of the jigsaw. You can't get away from that.
Lovely from Yusra Helmi, hanging in there. They're just stepping a bit behind the table to match the speed from Chun Meng. It's a very smart move.
3-6. Lovely angle again. Just makes it, we keep saying, it's just, that's made to look so simple when it clearly isn't.
Yeah, I just blinked my eye and the point was gone. Wonderful chop block from Yusra Helmi. I mean, to be confusing Chun Meng at that level, to be producing that, is just exceptional.
It takes some doing.
7-4.
You know, also the stamping on the of the feet while making a serve, I feel it could get so intimidating for somebody who's up against
Four,
Chang Meng.
Eight.
And she comes into the rally by that thump on of the feet. I would just want to be much more focused
Five,
if I am
eight.
Yusra Helmi here and not be intimidated by that.
But as you're alluding to, I mean, easier said than done. I mean, you think about this now, leader of the Chinese women's national team, as she is as well, imposing
Nine,
there, I think, is
five.
What you're getting at. You know, at the table, when you look at the other end of the table, you see, okay, there's no world championship singles title yet, but there's everything else. And then she has that stature as the leader of the team since Ding Ning's retirement. It's fantastic
Ten,
as well, she controls
five.
That. Out here to five game points. Again, clinical in the close. One more game required for Chang Meng here to complete the win.
One love.
Vicious.
Yeah, that was a beautiful down the line forehand attack.
Three,
what
one.
Was that? That was a nice side spin backhand receive. Just look at that ball, literally stopped in the air.
Four, one. One, five.
Entered across the maximum notch among for that matter. She's very, very much focused on trying to win the singles here. But two other events here for Helmi as well that she's entered here in Durban, the mixed and the women's doubles as well.
One, six.
Beautiful stepping around. This is probably the first time I've seen Chang Meng do in this match so far.
Out of reach there.
One.
She's playing mixed with Omar Assar's, with Khalid. Assar there, and women's dubs with Mariam Al-Hodabi.
Eight.
Just a punch
One.
There in the end.
Yeah, superb effort though. That's like the top players don't like losing a single point.
I was about to say now. 8-1 up.
3-8.
See the frustration there. A couple of points away. Standards that she sets herself, that the Chinese national team do. And we just see this tournament to tournament. The quest for perfection.
Nine,
and that
three.
Was getting close to it, that one. Away. Oh, gave it everything, Helmi. And Sarah, everything come back and more. That one's got to hurt a bit. She's dictating the point. Match points now. Oh, well played. Little
Four,
chopper in there
ten.
As well. Chop block in there and on the way to it. Might not change the outcome, but a match point saved. Still six more, though. This is the problem for Helmi. And there it is.
11,
all over here.
Gemma Mat
Chen's pursuit, quest for this elusive world championship singles title.